In general, Kiwis are far too nice, dodging conflict and not saying what we really mean. Our next guest believes it's holding us back and could be blocking our way to success. Welcome, Denise Golias. Hello, Denise. How are you?
Good morning. Thank you.
Now, one of the things you say is we want to be liked more than we want to be honest. Why do we do that?
Because we really want to fit in and conform with everybody else in the group.
Is there a difference between being honest and being overly critical?
Yes, I think when you're being critical, we actually come from a place that's really rather nasty or mean, and we're not in a kind space when we're doing it, whereas when we're coming from an honest space or a plain speaking space, we're actually coming from a place which is actually more loving and kind.
So we're not trying to hurt the people, we're just trying to help them.
Yes.
Why do we instantly do that? Because I know I do as well. If someone asks a question, I'll think of the answer and then I won't say it. Why do we censor ourselves?
Part of that conformity thing, and to the again coming back to that fitting in, there's also a fear of that, you know, what if somebody doesn't like me because of what I've actually really got to say, so I'll hold back from what I really want to say.
Is this something that's ingrained in us when we're younger as well, of not telling the truth?
Yes.
So is that like from society or from our parents that we get these bad habits?
It comes from a number of places, and you know, I wouldn't like to pinpoint and say that it's this or this or this.
Right.
It's you know, it's self-censoring as well. We have our inner voice, and our inner critic is the person that we listen to most often every day. I was watching a program the other day on the documentary channel, and our brain talks to us between 300 and 1,000 words a minute.
And we don't listen to it, do we?
Oh, we listen to it all the time.
But we ignore it?
Oh, it's often telling us stuff that's actually not helping us. We're our best worst critic.
Is this something that sort of you think is just in New Zealand, or is it worldwide?
I think it's worldwide. However, in New Zealand, I think straightforward talking has been something that we've moved away from because we would like to, you know, we fear the confrontation. We fear that we won't be liked.
Now, you, of course, work with a lot of businesses about bringing honesty into the workspace. What are the biggest problems you find in workspaces now?
Oh, email's got to be one of the biggest ones. I find people that will just email across the room or email to somebody that's right next to them. And email's not a really helpful communication tool. And I think the more personal the issue, the more likely or the more often you actually should get face-to-face and talk to somebody.
So you're saying that people will use email rather than actually communicating face-to-face?
And it's a really poor communication tool.
But you're also saying that you've come across businesses which are not that good in some ways, and they just like leave anonymous notes on people's desks. I mean, that just must take away all your power and make you feel awful.
It leaves people feeling very disempowered because they'll be standing there thinking, well, who left this? What's this all about? Is this somebody just being nasty to me, or is this something that I need to take on board? And that will linger in somebody for an awfully long time.
Does it also happen sometimes with businesses that you end up with someone who's kind of on the outer and becomes a bit of a scapegoat with the other group?
Can do.
Yeah. And that's something you don't want. And honesty will stop that from happening?
Honesty can stop that from happening. And it happens from employee to employee, but it also happens from employer to employee, where, you know, at the present time with the recession, there's an awful lot of fear. And so people aren't speaking up and saying what they need often in the workplace. But the business owner is also not saying clearly what they need from the business, from the people that are working for them as well, because they fear losing face. You know, what if they think I'm not a very good employer because maybe things are a bit difficult at the moment? However, if they actually spoke up and said something, the team might actually be able to rally together and really pull it off, because together everybody cheers a little bit more, don't they?
And you're saying that sometimes employers won't even tell their employees what they should be doing and haven't actually really explained their jobs to them as well.
Mm.
That's not helpful.
Not at all. I mean, they're sort of given a job description, and by ESP we have worked all out what we're supposed to do and where we're supposed to do it, how well we're supposed to do it, by what time are we supposed to be finished, what standard are we supposed to work to. And we often don't sit people down and say clearly to them, hey, listen, this is what I'm really expecting. At the moment, you're failing that, and what I need you to do is do this, this, and this, and we'll get you to where I need you to be. And, you know, we'll both be much happier if that occurs.
And a better workspace.
And a better workspace.
Now, let's have a look at some of these points when you're looking at to people and talking about them in honesty. Slow down. As in, like, actually listen to what the person's saying?
Slow down. Think about what you want to say, and then be thoughtful about the person that's in front of you as well, and think about how they're going to receive the information from you. So be aware of what space they might be in. Choose the moment, but don't avoid the moment, because
right.
I get a lot of procrastination
yes.
as well. So
everyone procrastinates.
Oh yeah, I'll do it tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. And you totally agree that face to face is always the best way.
If it's a personal issue, or if it's a human issue, or a work issue, performance issue, face to face is always best.
Because you can see the eyes as
yeah.
well.
Actually, you know, in terms of communication, 70% has nothing to do with the words.
Oh, it's what you pick up from what people...
It's the body language and how you're picking it up. So that's why I think face-to-face is just so important, and we need to learn to be more face-to-face with our communication.
I agree. And it's okay to say no.
It's totally okay to say no. I think a lot of women often do a lot of appeasing for everybody in their lives, and by appeasing too many people and not actually being clear about what you're wanting out of the situation, we feel even more disempowered and more robbed of, you know, our energy, our mojo, our get up and go, you know, so, and that's what I really want people to get.
And the thing I've learned is if you say yes to everything, sometimes you don't do things as well as you could or should.
Yeah, you're doing too many things, and it's better to be a master of some things.
And not the jack of all trade of
not
everything.
Not the jack of all trade.
So if there's one thing about honesty that you can sum up, what would you say, Denise?
It's about being thoughtful.
Right.
It really is that care and being thoughtful.
Excellent. Thank you so much for coming in. There's a lot to take in there.
Yes, there is. Now, there's one more thing. I do actually have a workshop next week.
I'm just about to mention that.
Oh, good.
Yes, thank you, Denise.
I'm so outspoken.
You're very upfront. Thank you. That was great. Now, Denise is running a seminar this month focusing on how to say what you mean and getting the most from your career. For more details, just see our website. And there'll be no holding back in your living room if you win this amazing high-tech prize.